How can Zoho Desk help you provide stellar multi-channel support? Before we get there, let's take a look at what multi-channel support is and why you need it. Your customers get in touch with you through multiple channels. It could be via email, phone, or if it's urgent, through live chat. The question is, are you equipped to support them through all of these channels? Just being present in all of them isn't enough. You should be able to continue conversations with the same customer across different channels effortlessly. For instance, let's say a customer calls you up to clarify some of her questions. You talk her through it and help her resolve the issue. A few weeks later, she gets in touch with you again, this time via email. Now here's the challenge. How do you know if she's been in touch with your company previously? If you start all over again, it shows your brand in a bad light. This is where Zoho Desk comes in. When your customer gets in touch with you through any channel, Zoho Desk will save their details and add them as a contact in your portal. So the next time the same person reaches out to you through another channel, you'd have plenty of context to quickly help them out. You'd know exactly who's trying to reach you, along with their past interactions with you. And this isn't limited to traditional channels of communication, but also channels that are increasingly popular today, like live chat, social media, the help center, and community. Apart from these channels, Zoho Desk also supports a number of APIs and web forms. Let's go through each channel now, starting with email. When you create an account in Zoho Desk, a default support email address gets created based on the company name that you entered. So when a customer sends an email to this address, it automatically converts into a support ticket. Your team can then respond to it from the home screen of Zoho Desk. Let's take the next channel now, the help center. Like the default support address, you also get a default URL for the help center. Simply put, this is a portal where your customers can look up answers to their questions without waiting for you. And what if you own more than one brand? No problem. You can set up a dedicated help center for each one thanks to multi-branding. Within each portal, your users will have the option to submit tickets to your agents. Let's look at one, say the Zphone. All you have to do is click on Submit a Ticket, fill up the form with the app details, and hit Submit. A ticket gets created in Zoho Desk, where your team can view and solve these issues. With the multi-brand feature, each ticket falls under the respective department and gets assigned to the concerned agent. In this case, it's the Zphone department. Within the help center, you also have the knowledge base, which is a repository of articles that your customers can refer to for answers. You have the option to categorize these articles so your customers can access them easily. But how do you upload these articles to the knowledge base in the first place? Let's open up Zoho Desk for that. You can select the knowledge base module from right here at the top of the home screen. To add an article, just click on the plus icon at the top here. Fill up the title, the description, and choose the category of the article on the right side. You also have an option to optimize this article for search engines by adding the title, keywords, and a description for the meta tags. Once you hit publish, this article gets pushed to your knowledge base in the help center. There it is, the article that we just published. Now to the next channel, the community, which is also a part of the help center. The community is where your customers can participate in forums and discuss their questions, problems, and ideas amongst themselves. As a support manager or an agent, you can also use the forums to post announcements to your customers. Let's take a look at the structure of the community feature. If you have multiple departments in your company, each one can host its own help center along with various categories and forum classifications. Now let's see how a customer can create a forum post. Once a customer signs up for the help center, they can use those credentials to log in. Clicking on the community link at the top opens up a page with a list of existing forum discussions. Customers can either click on a topic and make a post using the reply option, or they can start a new discussion after selecting the type and category. And the topic is now published. Customers can engage with this post by leaving comments, liking, or following this discussion. If you want to read through posts before they appear in the community, you can head to the moderation section within the community module. This is where all the posts that are pending moderation appear. You can either choose to approve and publish it, or you can delete it. You also have an option to create a ticket automatically when a customer posts in the community. Let's make a quick post here. This now appears in Zoho Desk as a ticket that an agent can work on. The next channel we're going to look at is live chat, the one that customers use when they need instant help. Zoho Desk gives you the option of embedding a chat widget in any of your web pages. All you need to do is get this snippet of HTML script and paste it in your web page's source code. You have the option to enable or disable the chat widget in the Help Center. Upon enabling it, the widget appears at the bottom right corner. When customers enter their question and hit send, agents get a pop-up in Zoho Desk prompting them to accept the chat request. When they accept it, they're automatically taken to the chat module. They can either chat with the customer or they can also convert this chat into a ticket at the click of a button. Let's move on to the next channel now, social media. Zoho Desk lets you engage with your Facebook and Twitter audience from a single screen. Just link all your Facebook pages with Zoho Desk and they'd show up in the social module on the left side. Now, when your customers or prospects post on your Facebook page, it shows up here. Let's take an example. We have Zilker's Facebook page here. A prospect makes a post inquiring about the release of the next generation Z phones. This will immediately appear within the social module. When an agent replies, it appears as a comment on the Facebook page. But if this is something that needs further action, they can simply convert this post into a ticket. You can reply to direct messages and engage in personal conversations as well. With Twitter, you can link all your handles with Zoho Desk. You can see them over here on the left. All the tweets that mention your handle appear here automatically. You can engage with your audience just the way you do on Twitter. You can like, retweet, and reply. You can also convert these tweets into tickets whenever needed. That would save your agent team a lot of time. Let's take a look at the next channel, web forms. A web form is an HTML form that's hosted on one of your web pages. Your prospects and customers can simply fill in the details and submit them as tickets to your agents. To host a web form, all you need is a snippet of the HTML code from the setup screen here. Just paste it on your web page's source code to get your form online. It's that simple. The next channel we're going to look at is telephony. There are two kinds of telephony that Zoho Desk supports. One is by using Zoho Phone Bridge, and the other is by enabling cloud telephony. Both these options will allow you to make and receive phone calls from within Zoho Desk. Let's take the first one. What does a phone bridge do? Well, Zoho Phone Bridge connects Zoho Desk with either Asterisk or Elastic's PBX systems, basically your phones. Once you've got the phone bridge set up, you'd see a pop-up on Zoho Desk whenever you receive calls on your phone. Likewise, you can initiate outbound calls from Zoho Desk to your phone. Let's make an outbound call now. Click on this call icon that appears near the contact's name. If an agent's got more than one extension number, they'd be able to see this dialog box in which they can just choose the extension from which they'd like to place the call. They'd also have to specify the dial code, which tells Zoho Desk if it's a local or an international call. Once you've specified these two, a call gets initiated. You should be able to see a pop-up on the screen as your calls go through to your phone. You can convert your calls into tickets too. Just click on Add Tickets here and fill up the form that appears. Choose the Associate option over here. And there you have it. The call details now appear within the Time Entry tab of the ticket. You can also associate a call with an existing ticket. So this is an inbound call to the phone for which we're seeing a notification pop-up in Zoho Desk. Open up the ticket that you wish to link with the call and click on Associate Call option here at the bottom. There you go. The call has been linked with this ticket. Now let's look at cloud telephony. Zoho Desk integrates with a number of cloud telephony providers like Twilio, RingCentral, Amazon Connect, BabelForce, and many more. The advantage with cloud telephony is that you can do away with a physical phone and simply make and receive calls from within Zoho Desk. The first step, of course, is getting a number from one of the cloud telephony providers and linking that with your Zoho Desk account. Once you've done that, you're good to go. But there are some additional benefits with cloud-based telephony, like call transfer, call recording, and call queuing. All right, now that we're done with telephony, the next channel we're going to look at is API. API stands for Application Programming Interface. When you want another app to interact with Zoho Desk, APIs can help you configure how these can happen. So when is this useful? Let's say you're using another application in your company, like a homegrown CRM. And let's say that you need a ticket to be created on Zoho Desk whenever your salesperson updates something on your CRM. This is where Zoho Desk's API can help you. With your development team's help, you can use Zoho Desk's API to send and receive data between the two apps. To know more about how your developers can use these APIs, you can visit this website. The link provides a complete list of actions that are possible on Zoho Desk. So go ahead and try out all these channels. If you need any help setting them up, you can check out our setup articles for that. Thank you and happy ticketing.